Hello everyone and welcome back to Age of Empires Castle Siege. Back we are, we have to collect some apples here and oh, we have to upgrade our silos here. Well, that's the lumberyard, that's not a silo. Otherwise we can't store all those delicious apples. So let's upgrade that with logs. Yeah, let's do that. So we can actually collect our apples here. Of course we need to wait for that unless we want to spend money on that. And we also need to upgrade our lumberyard. Let's do that now, and that costs us more apples, which we don't have because we haven't upgraded our apple silo yet. Do you see where this is going? I mean, you probably saw that during the last episode, but wasn't there some sort of reward chest here? Maybe just saw, maybe just imagined that. In any case, so we don't have done any of the training scenarios or historical challenges. I guess we are going to do that at one point. Yeah, that was the army capacity thingy. Okay, do we want to do this? I guess it doesn't really cost us much, so I guess we may as well do this if I find out how to actually do that. Let's see, can we... Or do we have to do that here? Whatever, we're going to find out at one point. Let's collect all of our... Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Okay, so we don't have enough apples for that, so we need to wait for that. So we are essentially wasting resources, but that's okay. What we can check out is whether we can build anything that's interesting. So we have... Oh, we've got some loot here. Do we have loot? Oh, by loot they just mean we can buy their fake currency. That's alright with me. Do we want to upgrade anything? Not really, because we need to upgrade our lumberyard first. This goes hard into... Festival market. This goes hard into the you have to wait or pay immediately before you can do anything category quite early, even for a game like this. In any case, let's check out the training scenarios. Plunder resources with your spearmen. So let's do that. One benefit of attacking other players is plundering their resources. Every building you attack, except defensive buildings, hold resources. The keep holds the most, followed by storage structures, then collectors. Other buildings hold few resources. Spearmen are a decent all-around troop to attack buildings. You'll learn more about them later. Okay, so let's accept the challenge, which I suppose it's just against the AI. Yep, note the different building types. What holds the most loot? Deploy your troop. Your troops here. And oh yeah, we have to choose an empty area outside. I guess we may as well deploy them all here because it doesn't look like there's any defenders, so... Let's just go from building to building and loot this mill here. And of course we've already reached our maximum here, so this isn't really going to get us much unless we... Oh, so they do have defenders here. Interesting. So I thought they didn't have that. Can we... Yeah, we can cause you to attack that keep here. Let's do that first. I don't think we are likely to lose here, but if you lose more spearmen, this is just going to take longer, because then we need more time to loot the rest of the fortress here. And we have so many troops that you can almost surround this in its entirety. And there we go. Yeah, one thing I have to say about this game is that it's at least more polished than a lot of other games of its kind, but that doesn't really make it all that different with regard to gameplay, naturally. And yeah, it seems to go really hard into the you have to wait or pay area fairly quickly compared to a couple of other games of this kind here I have checked out. Alright, we have reached our maximum, at least almost. So there's only 4 apples and 4 logs back in this building here, I assume. And there we go. Battle complete. How exciting. We get 20 gold coins. Alright, I guess we can move on to the next challenge immediately. Many troops have a preferred target. When near a preferred target, the unit will attack it even if something else is closer, unless you order them otherwise. The infantry in this scenario prefer to attack towers. Try deploying them between the two storage structures. Note what building they attack. Destroy the tower. Deploy your infantry and see what they target. Okay, let's see how this goes. Oh, okay. So let's target our infantry here. So these guys here like to attack the tower. These guys here like to stab the apples and the lumberyard. As spearmen do. Also, You've got these logs flying, these apples flying. That is sort of funny. And there we go. No loot from these buildings here. I assume it's just there to teach you what unit likes what. And here we go. So we do have a rock, paper, scissors system, or rather a sword, lumber yard, apple storage system. But that's okay. Let's check out the next one. How many of these are there again? Was it 20? It was 20 indeed. We may as well go through these, I suppose. Take out the tower's crossbowman damage bonus. Many units get damage bonuses to certain targets. Their main damage bonus is listed in their info panel. Crossbowman's primary bonus is against towers. See how quickly a crossbowman destroys the tower because of their damage bonus. Note how quickly the crossbowman destroys the tower. Deploy your troops. Okay, let's deploy them here. I wonder whether you can get anything interesting for the gold. I know you can use it to speed things up, but I wonder whether there's anything that's... Well, oh. I thought they were to destroy the apple storage as well. Just to demonstrate that it doesn't fall as quickly as the tower, but whatever. Protect the tower, kill us by tanking with infantry. That was a sentence. Some troops can withstand a lot of damage, while others deal out lots of damage. By getting enemy defense to shoot your high health troops, called tanking, you can maximize the destruction of your high damage troops. This is a key strategy. Deploy your infantry first to shield your crossbowmen from harm. Keep your crossbowmen safe by deploying infantry against the tower first. Deploy your troops. So they're spelled maximize with an S, but I think they're spelled defense also with an S, so... What kind of, that's how Canadian English is it? In any case, it doesn't really matter. Our swordsmen here are going to tank, and the crossbowmen are going to destroy this tower here. And everybody's going to be happy. And there we go, battle complete. Exciting, and we get even more gold coins. Exciting indeed. Raid the loot with the raider unit. Oh, so these axemen here are special raiders. Raiders are fast unit that have a damage bonus against loot type buildings. See the plunder resource scenario for more on looting. They also have loot buildings as their preferred target. Deploy your raiders and watch them gobble up the loot. We can do that. Raiders target loot buildings at long range automatically. Deploy your troops. Alright, we're going to deploy them here and let's see what they actually go for. So they're very fast as it seems, and they're very crimson. Yep, they are indeed efficient against these kinds of buildings. Also, they're not efficient against the fort as it seems, even though I guess that's sort of loot building as well. There we go, battle complete. Yeah, this seems to be very tutorial-ish. But then again, the historical challenges are probably what... It's more of an actual challenge. Conquer any emplacement with ladder invaders. The defensive catapult emplacement delivers a shower of rocks over a wide area at long range. They are lethal to troops, especially if the attacking troops are bunched together. Ladder invaders specifically target and have a damage bonus against emplacements. Ladder invaders can circumvent walls with their ladders to attack the emplacements. Alright, let's see what awaits us here. Use ladder invaders to take out the catapult emplacement. Deploy your troops. So the catapult emplacement is here, so let's get the ladder invaders to invade here. There we go. So can the other guys follow on the same ladder, so is this exclusive to... Yeah, it seems it's exclusive to these guys here. There we go. And then we've destroyed the rest, but that's okay, because we now have guys on the inside. So this shouldn't be too much of a problem. Yeah, I think the ladder invaders alone can do this. And I guess you can bash down the... I guess you can bash down the walls? At least they are being attacked by the crossbowmen here. But it seems that's not very efficient. At least I don't really see the health bar of that gate. It does decrease, but very, very slowly, so... I guess that makes a certain amount of sense. So this is the moment for our ladder invaders to shine. Who are falling one by one, but then again... So does the keep. Not one by one, but it does crumble. And come on, almost there. There we go. Battle complete. Okay, so let's see what awaits us next. Ramps and siege towers can thwart that wall. Walls prevent your troops from reaching their targets. You need special units to defeat walls before your troops are slaughtered by the castle defenses. Battering ramps can take down walls quickly and have a bonus against gates. Siege towers allow your troops to scale the wall. Destroy this castle by using them. Okay. I guess the siege towers now function as de facto ladders that everyone can use. Use the ramps on the gates and the siege towers to get troops over the walls. Deploy your troops. Okay. Time to deploy the ramps. And siege towers. Here. There we go. And here as well. Castle breach. Excitement. And I guess maybe I should have deployed these guys here first. I'll just deploy you here because I can. I don't really care. I don't think we're going to lose this. If we are going to lose this, then I guess that's too bad. And I'll just deploy you here. Oh, you don't even bother taking that tower. That's okay. It's not. It's dead now anyway. And the battering rams will make short work of this keep here. Nice. There we go. So this game actually does have a resemblance of a strategy game. At least you don't have these semi-automated battles where you just watch tanks destroy one another at excruciatingly slow pace. So that's something, I suppose. There's one tower left. And boom. Even though this is more of a tactics game than a strategy game. Alright, what's next? Range them with archers, not outrage them. Archers are a good all-purpose ranged troop. Their range allows them to avoid castle defense while picking off outer targets. They can also shoot over walls. Archers do decent damage to buildings and are good as cleanup units. Use your archers to destroy the buildings inside the walls. Okay, we shall do that. Shoot over the walls to get at the targets. Deploy your troops. Okay, we can do that. Let's deploy them from all sides here. Oh, nope, I do not want to leave the battle. I just accidentally clicked on that surrender button. But that's fine. Yep, archers can indeed shoot over walls, as we have just demonstrated. And there we go, battle completes. Another glorious victory for, I guess, the Teutonic Order of the Knights. Protect yourself and deal with defenders. Speaking of which, I think you can actually be attacked by other players here. If you don't have a truth, I don't know what that means, because you can get yourself destroyed, but whatever, we'll see about that later. Castles have their own troops that are deployed from patrol points, and guardhouses. Guardhouses can continue to deploy troops as long as the building survives. You should deal with defensive troops quickly, either by destroying them or drawing them away. Make sure you take out guardhouses early. Alright. Crossbowmen have a bonus against troops and archers can shoot the guardhouse over the wall. Deploy your troops. Okay, so we want to deploy the battering ram here. I guess we can deploy all of our archers here. Let's deploy you here and... Oops, that's not what I want to do, but never mind. These look very grey. I know that most of these troops are somewhat monochrome. And we mostly have these purple, green and grey troops here. But the grey guys look kind of weird. They look like they're little golems. Also, why did you not attack? I guess you didn't attack the gate because the gate's actually way tougher than the wall. So I guess that does make sense. Yeah. I guess it does make sense. In any case, guardhouse is down, so let's just watch these guys destroy the castle. Which seems to be needlessly tough. Because destroying the castle isn't really a challenge, is it? Then again, this is a tutorial, so there isn't really any challenge in the first place. There we go, battle complete. Once more, we're raking in the victories and raking in the gold. Crush them with cavalry. Yeah, we can do that. Cavalry have a damage bonus against most food troops. They are foot troops. They are excellent against defending units and do a decent job of taking down defense as well. Watch out for spearmen, as they have a damage bonus against cavalry. You should use crossbowmen to take out the spearmen. Just like in Age of Empires 2. Alright, let's do that. Use cavalry against defending troops and towers, but avoid the spearmen. Okay. So, let's see. I guess we want to deploy you here, you here, you there, you here, and... You know what? Let's just do it like this. This should be good enough. The spearmen are here. Can we just ignore them? Because they don't seem to be interested in... No, we cannot, because those guys just go for them. Oh, well. Well, that's your fault. You didn't have to do that. I guess I could have deployed my archers here to destroy these guys first, but we still have enough of them left. So we should be alright, hopefully. If not, then I guess that's too bad. But these guys here seem to be quite fast and also efficient against this keep here, so we'll be fine. I wonder whether that keep can even reach the crossbowman, because if it can't, then there's no real way to lose this. Also, this is going to recharge in the foreseeable future, but I think I'm going to win this before they deploy more troops anyway, so no need to worry about that. And that went down quickly. Yep, no problem whatsoever. Yeah, that's a very brittle building. Our cavaliers are just that good. In any case, we have a ton of gold. Let's briefly go back to... Ooh, we're now a tactician. To our town, let's see whether we can do anything. Ooh, apples. So we can't really collect more logs, but we need rewards. That's nice to know. Let's see. Oh, wait a second. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Oh. Did I want to do this? I'm not quite sure. Anyway, let's take out this tower here first. And then we can see what we can do here. So is this Sinless Coda something something? Okay, so we're just beating up some hapless guy here. Which seems to be rather easy because they only have this tower here, so after that we've pretty much won. Well, they also have the keep that can strike back, but they're generally not strong enough to key award it, okay, whatever that means. So I guess we're just ganging up on another player here. I think that can happen to you while you are not actually on your device, which is not so great, but then again it's just another mechanic to encourage you to spend more time with this game here than you probably should. Then again, yeah, at least we have an easy time winning this. Yeah, what are you guys doing? Oh, I guess you can't walk through the ruins. I guess that sort of makes sense. And we get some fancy more keys. Okay, I can deal with that. We will probably have maxed out our resources soon. So I guess we need to build more storages or so. You guys have a tendency of going into the wrong direction briefly before you then walk to the next target you're actually supposed to walk to. But that's okay, it's just kind of weird. Also nice burning effect there with the keep. They did put some effort into the graphics here. It's your colorful mobile graphics, but at least it does look nice. Victory. Looted. So we have a bunch of logs, a bunch of apples, and castle destruction was the end result. And we've got two keys, which I suppose we can use to unlock loot box, something like that. In any case, I guess that also gets us, yeah, daily combat rewards, because we, yep, because you have to play this game. Whoa, that's not what I wanted to do. My empire, yeah, I've been promoted to the Peasant League, isn't that exciting? You get special chest rewards when you battle. Select the battle chests button to view your available chests. Let's view our available chests. So army archery range, yeah, that sounds good to me. You get special chest rewards when you... Okay, so we already had that. That's okay. So that takes, of course, an hour, because why wouldn't it? But we can invest some gold points. But let's see. Any case, so we do have various types of chests here, naturally. Welcome to your battle chests screen. Every day you get 9 chests full of awesome rewards to open. The small chests on the right show how many special chests you have left to open for the day. These change every time the chests reset. The key icon at the bottom on the screen shows how many keys you have. Each key opens one chest. Earn keys by battling. You receive one key when you destroy 20% of the enemy's castle and another one when you destroy 60%. The timer near the top of the screen starts counting down from 24 hours when you first log in for the day. When the timer runs out, you will get a full new set of 9 chests. Any unopened chests and unused keys from the previous day will be lost. So you better spend too much time with this game. You have keys available, select a chest to open. I guess we're just going to go in order because I have no idea what is in any of these. Tap to open. So did we just open a blue chest, and then in the blue chest was a red chest of the same size, and in those were logs. Which of course we didn't really need to. Enjoy your rewards, you've earned them. Special honor items are available only from these chests, so keep opening them every day. Yeah, naturally. Of course we already were maxed out on logs, so you can't really do anything with that. What we can do is probably get farm. No, we want a storage actually. Okay, so let's see. Boosts, fortifications, military. So, oh, so there's more here. Silo. So we can't build multiple. So at the moment, it doesn't seem like we can really do much here. We can build roads, but that costs us a lot of gold. Or does it? Wait a second. Wait a second. Can we just build that? Can we decide where we want to build that, or does this? Oh, I guess you have to go through the set path here. So what does that even cost us? Is it just a daily thing? Maybe it is. In any case, so this is the attack log screen. This is where all of our attacks are recorded. Exciting, exciting. Each battle lists the unit deployed and the percentage of castle destroyed or protected. It also shows how much plunder you gained or lost. Okay. This is a visit button. You can view enemy castles by using this button. Okay. This is a retry battle button. Use this button to practice this fight again. You won't get any rewards for retrying a battle, but remember, practice makes perfect. That's actually a nice touch. Once you join an alliance, this button allows you to post a retry battle to your alliance to try out once a day. It's a great way to learn new strategies and get feedback from other commanders. I always review my battles to improve my strategy. Use the view replay button to watch a replay of your battles. People know my name because I share my exploits. You can do the same by using the share replay button once you join an alliance. Yeah, I look forward to seeing your heroic replay as well. Yeah, that's what Richard the Lionheart's known for, his famous battle replays. In any case, so build capacity is 3 out of 4, so what can we actually build? So we can't upgrade this because we can't get any. Yes, we can upgrade this. No, we can't upgrade that either because it costs us 1,300 apples and we can only get 1,200. What a coincidence. We could upgrade this, the lumber yard. Can we upgrade the apple yard here? Let's just do that. Yeah, whatever. We have nothing to spend our logs on anyway. There we go. We can upgrade that. I guess so. We do need gold for that. I guess we may as well do that. Oh, actually, no, we don't want to do that because I thought it was the upgrade, but this was just the finishing touch. And do we want to upgrade this? Yeah, whatever. And that takes 2 minutes. We can wait that long. What does leveling up this costs? Oh, wait a second. Oh, we can upgrade these guys here. Let's upgrade these. Nope, can't do that. Can we upgrade those guys here? Naturally, we cannot do that, even though we were close. Yeah, but anyway, I think this is it for the day. Thanks for watching, and I shall see you next time. Take care and goodbye.